everybody, Colin here from Colin's Engage. I'd like to wish you all a happy new year and I hope you had a great Christmas. Been rather busy working and doing other bits and doing stuff with the layout. New year, not a new start, but the plans of starting the station has started. And the first thing I've decided to do was see if I could make the escalators. Because I'm going to be doing they've got to get across the track. So there's going to be escalators down and stuff like that. So basically, that's what I've been up to and I've got one done and that's what I'm going to show you. The finished article and bits of it, how I got to that stage. So that's that, and then something I've got to show a scale speed of the trains. Now I'm wanting to do this because I don't want to run trains faster than what they should be going at, no matter what the make, country or whatever. So a HST, if I want to run it at full speed, I want to know what to put the controller at that for that particular model, because every model will go different and all chips are different because I don't stick to one particular chip, so they're all different. Now I know that you can go into the settings, into CV settings, and alter the speed by altering how much voltage and things like that. Not particularly bothered about doing that. May have to run some if they're not going fast enough, or they're just going as fast as I can get it to go. Because I do know when sometimes, I don't know if you found this with your controllers, they actually get to the top end speed fairly quickly on a controller. It might be at 70 or 80, 90 even. And then after that, the 90 to say 126, the speed don't alter at all. So it's things like that. And it's something interesting to do. To know what speeds they're actually going at. It's just nice to know. So I will show you that. But otherwise than that, let's get on with the video. Right, we've decided to start making some progress on the station. But first, I wanted to see if we could make escalators. So these are the steps. Now, what we're going to show you now is the machine cutting the little squares, which are slightly different to them. They're 10 by 6 and the ones we're going to use are 10 by 10. And we just give it a quick dose of paint just to see what it looks like. So this is a machine cutting it. And we're cutting out 180 steps. And they've got to be glued into lots of 60. I think we're mad, but never mind. Right, that's 180 steps. That's what it's come out of. And they're stuck to the white bit. Now to be just picked off. And then start gluing. Okay, so we've glued a rake of steps together. There's 59 there, I think. Or 50, maybe 56. Now, then I've got my sides. Now, there's three bits to each. Two are, they're already glued. And then there's that one to go on this outer edge, because what we've done is we've, if we can focus in, We've kept a rebate. Let's try to focus it. Come on. Down there. Unfortunately, it's focusing on a lot. Focus on that. And that's to put a back on it. So the under, you don't see the underneath of the mechanism and the steps moving, in theory, when you look in stores and escalators around the world, it all has a back on. So that's why that's to that sticking a mill up, but this outer edge will stick flush. Like that one. And then there's a pair, one way and one the other. And these will be all painted silver on the inside. And the silver up to that point. Then this bit and underneath and up the other side is going to be in a creamy colour. So it reflects light and stuff like that. So once I've got them all glued to this and three pairs, then we can glue the steps in, but we're going to paint it first. And down the edge, it looks mucky because of glue, but that'll all get covered. But down the edge of each side is going to be yellow. Because on some escalators, round by where we are, we have a yellow edge, so you know not to stand too close to the edge. So you stand more in the middle. So that's what's happening. And this is the start of the station, as I said. Now, we've got three pairs, but we need six pairs. So we'll just get the machine to cut another set out. So that'll be 380 steps, 360 steps altogether cut out. But thankfully, we've got the scan and cut machine, which makes it very accurate. Right, so first one complete with a few people on. It needs some ladies. At the moment, it's all men going to menswear, even though it's a station. So, anyway, that's the, when you look at it from the side, pleased with all the heights and measurements. This bit at the front will get cut into the station platform because those go underground, ready to go back up. And what we're going to do is when the other one goes next to it down, in between, sat on that edge, there'll be another silver piece. And in theory, it has no smoking on. But we'll just put something so people don't slide down it. You know what kids are like, you know, and adults. So we can have that. And then up the side, what will get attached to each side of this from possibly about this height all the way up will be a glass screen. So people can't jump off, because there's a few idiots who think if they jump off, they get on train quicker. So it'll hopefully look all right. Won't be glass. It's going to be plastic see-through stuff, but that's what it'll be there for. And the top, again, that's higher, but again, that goes in, and it actually measures the exact height as well for the first go. And there's 59 steps. And what I did for the bottom and the top bit, just did smaller ones because just to show it starting off. Let's focus. Started on, it always starts off on flat before it goes up. But very, very pleased. So there's 59 steps. There's 59 going up. There's 4 and 2 there. So that's 65. Seven, 69, 71, 72, 73, and 6 bits here, which you can't now focus with there, in there. So that's 78 pieces of card to make that. And we are extremely over the moon with it. So there's three more to do. No, there isn't. There's five more to do. Yeah. Because there's got to be three up and three down. So more cutting. But using the machine. If you can imagine cutting all that out by hand, it would be quite hard work. So that machine is really doing a good job for us. So very pleased. So onward and upward, and this is the start of the station. Well, we have a parcel here, and it's being delivered through the United States Postal Service, which gives you a clue, it's come from United States. So I've seen one of these before and I thought it was about time, having some of these fast trains like the bullet train, I want to know what actual speed it's going, and this should tell us. So let's have an open and have a look. So this is what's in it, a speedometer. As you can see, there's double OHO and the ends. Can't do O gauge because it can't go through it. This is like a little tunnel that goes through. So let's get it a little bit more out and see what it can do. Right, I've had a quick read of the instructions, very simple. I've got it set up for my N-gauge, as in most of the British stuff and European stuff. To run the Americans through it, you have to just change the setting. But when you turn it on, it just tells you what it's doing, so it's N in miles an hour. And 148 scale, and that's it, it's ready to rock and roll. Basic thing is, doesn't matter which way the train is going, it can go in from that way or that way. And if I use the hand as the example, it's going in, it shows that it's working there, and when it comes out at the other end, basically my hand did 5.5 miles an hour in N gauge. So I've got very small hands. But that's as simple as it works. You can have it in kilometres, and you have different scales. And basically, to set it, you just press the button what's inside that hole, so it's showing the N, HO in kilometers, Ain American in kilometers. Because I didn't press it enough, it's now set at the American. So I'll just have to turn it off and turn it on. Because once it goes off, it sets itself. And then 00 in kilometers, in British in kilometers, HO in miles per hour. So basically you just go through it until you find the one you want. You just let it flash and it tells you the scale when it's 00 and HO, and then you turn it off and turn it back on again and it's set. And that's it. That's how you just set it up. Very simple. And then put it over your track and run trains past. So I'll show you that in action. So I've got a HSTO, a GNER, and it's at full speed on the throttle. It's quite cold in here at the moment, and as it warms up it may go a little bit faster. But what I'm wanting to know is what speed the trains are travelling at when it's at a certain, see it's warmed up a bit, so it's gone up to 129. To run them at a scale speed. So as this is warming up, it may get over the 130s this time, may not. At 130. One, two, six. So I'll have to just try and go down what that does. Yeah, I thought it would be 121 because it's gone down to 69 and I need to get 70. Out of it. That's 70, so 124. So what I'll do is I would make a note now that 70 with a 43 GNER running forward gives me the scale speed of 124 miles an hour. So I now know what that is. So if I then run another train, say I was going to run a 60 there, and I was running it at 60 mile an hour, in theory it would be going half that speed. Well, it will be, but in the real, you know, on my layout, it will be exactly half that speed if it was going in the same direction. It would pass it in a certain amount of time. Yeah, constant. So I've got a lot of testing and running and sorting out to do, and I'll show you different. But one of the reasons I wanted it for is for ice, the bullet trains I've got, the 800s, what all come from Kato. Because they run fast, as you've seen in the past, but I don't want to run them faster than what they are in the real world, if you know what I'm trying to get at. So, and then I'll have to find out information, what each train runs at. That's quite consistent, is that? Different makes, as in classes, at the maximum speed, and the same with the steam engines as well. So one more time, and that is quite consistent. I hope that was interesting. Shorter for me, that video. I will show you what's come for the start of the new year in the next video, hopefully. And maybe a bit more to do with this station area. And the other thing for doing the station, if I need to do any alterations, I need to do that before I fix any points, as in with motors or the double slips, if I need to move the track over a bit, so I don't need to alter any of the points, the actual point motors, the servos, and then I can actually put down ballast in that area, so it's permanent then. So I just needed to get the widths of stuff, to know what width of platform and stuff like that. So that's it for this one. I hope you continue to all be well, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now. Bye.